Here's the Dubois theorem, and I'm going to rewrite it up again once more so you can see clearer. Basically, the Dubois theorem says that a complex number expressed in this way, RCIS data, raised to the power of n, is basically R to the power of n CIS the n theta. What it means is basically this. The complex number, when it's raised to the power of n, the modulus is going to be multiplied by itself n times, that is raised to the power of index n, where else is the angle or the argument will be added to itself n times. And let's say I start with this is my z, and let's say this is 2 units, and this is my angle theta. And if I want to have z squared, then what happens is that angle theta here will be added to itself theta times, so it's rotating anti-clockwise another theta. So now it's 2 theta, and this modulus now, before was 2, now it's going to be 2 squared, will be 4 units, so this is my z squared. If you want to have z cubed, then this will be rotated theta, 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 3 theta, alright, it's going to be like this. So here total is 3 theta, and it will be stretched 2 to the power of 3, 8. So the modulus now is 8, and this is z cubed, for example. Now, in the IB exam, you'll be required to know how to prove this using a mathematical induction for all positive integer n. And in fact, this Dubois theorem can be expanded to be n being a rational number. So you can have fraction on top. You can have positive and negative fraction on top. If you do get, for example, z to the power of negative 2, then what it means is this, right? Before is 2. So you can think of this like 1 over z squared, kind of. Alright? So your modulus now is going to be 2 raised to the power of negative 2, that means going to be 1 quarter, and then you're going to be rotating backward theta, 2 theta, that means it's around here, and it's going to be not as long, but only a quarter of the distance, that means z to the power of negative 2, for example. So for negative, we are rotating clockwise, and you have a shrinkage, whereas for when n, the index is positive, you get stretched out and you're rotating in a anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so let's see how we can find the answer to this. 1 plus I to the power 4, right? Z raised to the power 4. So first thing is to put this into an Eigen diagram. Alright, so like this, 1 unit and 1 unit. Okay, this is an I here. So here is pi over 4. So the radius here is 1 unit, 1 unit. So the modulus here is square root of 2. So I can rewrite this as square root of 2 CIS pi over 4. And then everything is raised to the power of 4. Using the Dubois theorem, this is square root of 2 raised to the power of 4 CIS. And then 4 times pi over 4. Well, this is relatively easy. So the answer to this is 2 raised to the power of 2, that is 4 CIS pi, for example. So you can change this back into rectangular form if you wish, which is 4 of, you can think of it, where is this in rectangular form? 4 pi. Pi is around here, and then 4 unit somewhere around here, so this is going to be negative 4 here. So, in fact, if you actually simplify this, the answer here is just going to be negative 4.